In this video, we'll discuss two topics, training and promotion. So starting with training. Training is an activity which involves the development of hidden talent of an individual and uses it for the benefit of organization. So with the help of training process or activity, we can develop person's personality, talent and skills so that he can be beneficial for the organization. Now we'll see the importance of training. Maintenance and improvement of current jobs and developing skills in employees for future jobs helps organization improving efficiency. Motivate the employees. So with the first point, we can say with the help of training, a person can maintain his current job, improves his current job, and also for future job he can develop skills with the help of regular training. So when there will be trained personnel in the organization, automatically the efficiency of the organization will improve. And also when the organization is getting good results, employees get motivated. Also employees get motivated due to training and skills given or provided to them. They will have a feeling of security because they know how to perform procedures, activities in the organization with the help of training. Training also identifies and satisfies the individual needs, working according to the expectation of higher authority, helps in understanding and resolving the problems of the organization. So this is how it is important for the employees. Now, types of training. Induction training is nothing but a training which is given to the new recruits or the people who are newly joined to any organization. Next is job instruction training. In this type of training, the job overview is given and the experienced person or trainer will demonstrate entire job. Next is vestibule training. In this, the training is regarding how to do procedure away from the workplace. Next is refresher training. It is used when there is need to provide latest or updated knowledge regarding the field. Next is apprenticeship training. It includes on-the-job training methods and off-the-job training methods. On-the-job training methods include methods which we are using during the job. While we are working in the ward or while we are working in the work area, at that time these methods are used. Off-the-job training methods are used after the job is done or after your work timing. So, on-the-job training methods include job rotation, coaching, job instruction, committee assignments, internship training. Off-the-job training methods include case study method, role play, incident method, lectures, simulation, management education, conferences. Next, we'll see promotion. Promotion is a term which covers a change and calls for greater responsibilities and usually involves higher pay, better terms and condition of service and therefore a higher status or rank. So whenever person gets promoted, he gets higher rank as well as higher pay with higher facilities or better facilities. Promotion is an advancement of an employee to a better job. Better in terms of greater responsibility, more prestige or status, greater skill and especially increased rate of pay or salary. Now, first purpose of promotion is to utilize the employee's skill knowledge at the appropriate level in the organizational hierarchy. A person gets promoted when he or she is having better qualities or skills than others, so that his or her qualities can be utilized for higher level. To develop competitive spirit and inculcate the zeal in the employees to acquire the skills, knowledge, etc. required by higher level jobs. To develop competent internal sources of employees ready to take up jobs at higher level in changing environment. To promote employees' self-development and make them await the turn for off promotions, it reduces labor turnover. Promote feeling of contentment with the existing condition of the company and a sense of belongingness. To promote interest in training development programs and in team development areas. Next is to build loyalty and to boost morale. To reward committed and loyal employees. Then it creates and increases the interest of other employees in the company as they believe that they will also get their turn. Next is it improves morale and job satisfaction. It improves organizational health. Thank you.